You are the only father I've ever had.
Tovi.
Eivor, it's Sven. He passed while I was away.
Tovi, I'm sorry I wasn't there.
No one was. We had planned to brand Tekla's barrels that morning, and we talked about what we might have for supper. And when I went to collect him, he was in his bed, sleeping, I thought. But he was already gone.
I'm sure he went in peace.
But he went with plans. Things he wanted to do, things he meant to do. His death was so empty. Not like in our stories. When we tell stories, the old and wise, they have this calm about them. They know when their end has come and they're ready. Sven wasn't ready, and I wasn't ready either. He was supposed to teach me things. I'm still learning. Everyone looks at me like I will simply carry on his work, as if nothing happened, because they don't know. They don't know I'm not ready.
Life may ask more of us than we are prepared to give, but all we can do is our best. I was not prepared to lose my parents, but in a flash, they were taken from me. I pressed on, determined to live.
That must have been punishing. But you are so strong and so determined.
Someone else might have done better than me, or worse. But this was the fate woven for me, so I live it. I know Sven believed in you, in your craft. So do you believe in him? Do you trust him?
He was the most skilled artist I have ever known.
And he chose you. You may step up or step down, whatever you decide. But know that he had faith in you.
Thank you, Eivor. I need to get home.
Be strong, Tovi. And know you are valued.
The Order has been purged from London. For now, they hold no power there.
That is good news. And I would celebrate, but for the fact that Jorvik now suffers from the same infestation.
Jorvik is a city under Norse control. I should have less problems finding allies there.
That is a hopeful way of seeing it. Speak to Ranvi when you wish to travel there. I have something here for you. Tidings that may displease you.
Tell me.
You remember Kjotve's son, Gorm? He has since taken his father's place in the Order.
Interesting. He's got him here in England. Is he another blotch on our list?
He is one of our targets, yes. But he is not in England. He is further west, in fact. A land called Vinland, discovered centuries ago by an Irish sailor called Brendan. The Order of the Ancients has some recent fascination with Vinland, but I cannot say what it might be.
Let me find out for you, after I silence Gorm.
Vinland is far away, according to my source. It may take weeks to find him after a long and perilous journey.
There's no danger that would cow me, Hytham. I will speak with Ranvi and arrange passage.
Was there something else?
I have to go.
Then go in peace.
Good traveler, what seek you? Perhaps I can help. Where is the matter of my fee?
All right.
Look here, the spot I'll mark on your map. A place I know.
Side must be barred.
Yeah.
Best brace my hood.
These soldiers are tightly wound. Show me. An alehouse. This must be it.
If Shakhawa with and
the secret is not here. I'll ask around.
These soldiers always leave a bleeding mess.
Are you the alewife here?
You are not welcome here. I've had enough trouble with Danes today.
I'm not here to cause trouble. I'm looking for my brother, a large Norseman.
It was him what caused the ruckus. Him and that other one were here, talking to Thane Giedrich. Then Lady Edwin's soldiers swept in. A fight broke out. Your brother and the tanned fella got away. The soldiers nabbed Giedrich, though. I was sorry to see that. He's well-liked in these parts.
Which way did my brother go?
What's it worth to you to find out?
I'm asking a simple question.
Look, Dane, you start a scene or a scuffle, and I'll scream for soldiers. Thieving Carter. Here's your silver. Thank you kindly. Your brother and his friend jumped through that window and ran for the river. I'd wager they hid in one of the fish houses there.
Sigurd and Basim headed south. They wouldn't go far. I'll check along the river. Go, my eyes. Smells like a fish house. Good spot to hide.
Wait! Stop!
Alan wa sahlan, Eivor.
We could have caught you to bloody giblets, Wolfkist.
Why so unnerved, brother? It's not like you.
Half the soldiers of the Shire are hunting us. You must have noticed.
Is that why you haven't come home? You're playing hide and fetch with the Mercian soldiers.
Your brother's a busy man, Eivor. Weighed down by pressing duties.
It's good to see you again, Basim. Even if you haven't kept my brother trained on the task at hand.
It's not my place to lead your brother about like a bridled mare.
Now there's an idea. Brother, we should be forging alliances. Send this man back to his warren before he leads you astray.
Eivor, gods above, I'm grateful you've joined us. We have made strides towards an alliance, in fact. A local thane called Gidritz has pledged an oath to me.
I've heard of him. The alewife also mentioned a Lady Edwin who commands the soldiers. Why not ally with her?
Lady Edwin's husband was the Shire's elderman, until Gudrun's army ended his life. Now she's taking up her husband's fight, with the promise of aid from King Alfred of Wessex.
Edwin vows revenge on the Danes who stole her husband and her livelihood.
From what we know, Alfred is a fearsome king. If Edwin can win his full support, this Shire is lost to Wessex.
So to fight her, you've pledged your sword to a minor thane who likely commands a gang of farmers and fishermen.
Have faith, Eivor. A few hundred Saxons armed with hayforks and billhooks can be terrifying.
Gods!
All men and women, noble or peasant, have within them the seeds of something greater.
This is true. Sometimes greater than the average mind can fathom.
Well, Edwin has Giedrich in shackles now. All your plotting has turned to ash.
Not if we act soon. She dragged her prisoners to the Longhouse. With you here, we can mount a surprise strike.
If Giedrich is our best chance for an alliance, let's see it done. Sigurd. Has Basim talked you into something of little reward?
Eivor, have you lost hope in my warcraft? I heed Basim's wisdom, but he follows my lead, always.
He has the look of one who trusts none but himself.
Basim is secretive by nature, but he is wise and forthright. And he has opened my eyes to a magnificent truth. He has promised me a reward so unusual, so incredible, it will shatter your mind to shards.
Brother, our bond has the iron heft of a war axe. Do not let Basim and his prophecies of good fortune sway you from our simple goal.
Never. Our goal is fixed. We shall soon be the lords of Mercia, then all of England. But Basim has a deep insight. He's read wisdom in the lines of my face and heard the litany of my forefathers, and well, there will be time enough for my saga later.
Okay. gentleman there, yeah?
Sins. Flank the idiot. Press hard. I'll take you.
Can't do this alone.
Sigurd, kill this sweaty fishwife.
Stay your blades. This traitor Giedrich will face trial, as will all the treasonous thanes of this shire.
You're the traitor, Edwin, calling on Alfred of Wessex begging for his army.
Clap your mead hole, Giedrich, lapdog of the Danes.
You'll sell us out to Wessex, and that poxy-ass bastard Alfred. We won't have it.
Lady, there's no need for slaughter. We all want peace for Xenofortshire. Can we find some agreement?
You heathenish fork-tongued Dane. Foul-smelling heap, I shit on you all.
Lady, choose your next words with care. For you see before you the future master of all England, Sigurd of the Hungry Raven Clan. Lay down your arms. Free my friend here, and kiss my lordly feet. You will not get a second chance.
Sigurd, are you cracked?
And you can kiss my rosy red arse, wayface. I've done with this offal. I leave them to you. Flay them alive and tan their flesh for saddles.
We keep our wits about.
Giedrich, what have they done to you?
What kind of mess did you get yourself into?
Untie me! I can still fight these bastards!
Throw me a spear!
Here, take it!
You should have freed me!
Giedrich, this is Eivor, my stone-armed sibling.
Well met.
That was your plan, Sigurd, to charm the lady with your vague hope of kingship.
Prophecy, Eivor, not hope.
No time to squabble. Edwin's taken most of the Shire's thanes. She has her way. They'll be dead by supper.
Tend your wounds, Giedrich. We'll free your friends.
And what of the holy woman, Fulke? You promised us a meeting with her.
I did, aye. But it's a fair mystery why you'd want to talk
with...
Where
is she?
Thane Holt will know. Fulke lives on his lands, but he'll be dead with the rest if you don't stop the trial.
tell us where, and we'll go now. Their lives depend on the speed of your tongue.
Southwest of here, halfway to Oxenforda, at the Leech Vila garrison.
Basim, Eivor, to horse. Off again, Eivor. You and I, with blades drawn and hearts ablaze.
Who is this Fulke that Basim spoke of?
An ally, Eivor. A most important ally. A holy woman who trades in prophecies and secret knowledge.
That is not the sort of alliance we're looking for, Sigurd.
No, it's even better. You cannot imagine what discoveries await.
You're speaking strangely, brother.
Because I'm alive, Eivor. My heart's alight with the fuel of battle fire. Like old times, eh?
Yes, Sigurd. Like old times.
Remember our hunts beyond the Northern Way? Our first big kill was a 10-point deer. We brought it down together. The arrows from our bows like darts of ice.
With sharpened shin bones for skinning the beast.
You on the right, me on the left. We leapt and struck.
We crashed to the ground like a felled tree. Then the bloody struggle.
Damn animal bit my hand. Never knew a buck could bite so hard.
But I pierced its throat, spilling its life wine into the drifts. That put an end to him.
Such tales you siblings tell.
It's just one of a thousand, Basim. It was the glorious dawn of our lives.